A broken thing, a separation that kills, ways rejoice. And through our voices, broken mandala is made whole. And turns again, calling us away. And how through these gratitudes, everything we love can be saved.
Share what we have today. Here. gives advantage, but no special rights or immunity to ignore the effects of that exploitation or overconsumption on our planet. The powerful and the wealthy find no value in fair exchange. Their country has two states, profit and loss, haves and have-nots. So why are we so proud of having been an empire? Well, Henry VIII declared England empire for the chance of one legitimate son, binding his subjects over to total and humble obedience from then on. Unfurling sails, England went east and west to find trade routes, buccaneers and privateers making landfall wearing England's boots. Colonising and conquering countries from the indigenous and the free, local, then global, Great Britain changing the world's atlas and history. Over those waves, from ports, Bristol and Liverpool, fancy goods in exchange for slaves, buying and selling people, chattels packed shoulder to shoulder, 3 million individuals transported across that deep Atlantic water. Never say again that you did not know, still is true today. Queen Victoria longed to reign over us, happy and glorious. Empress of India, what cost that pomp, that circumstance? The world has changed, empire unraveled from under the British heel, but greed, spicy or sweet, remains such a profitable, palatable meal.
Little tired girl in a sweatshop then,
away!
Sometimes I just wish I could fly away, far from the stress and the pressures, from the unnecessary pressures, things that we used to measure. Success in this life, for things that bring chocolate pleasure. It's all work and no leisure, just to accumulate high-priced treasures that'll never last forever, so that we can compete with each other. It's like expensive things might give your life more value, and money might make people admire you and even desire you. But even when your pockets are full, your heart can still be empty. You can just be the source of someone's empty. I'm working my days away, when every payday came, it's always the same. Feeling like a king for a minute, then my bank balance hits the limit. And there's that familiar feeling of anxiety and panic, cause I'm living a lifestyle of credit. When will it sink in, when will I get it? Money bears a hole in my pocket cause I lend it. But this capitalism has got us all motivated by the same vision. Some are living nice and comfortable and some are in prison. And they might just be chasing freedom or looking for a hand to feed them. Cause I know the feeling, your hard luck, you can't pay the bills, it's hurting and it's freezing. And your distant needs are extensive and being alive is expensive. Yet you get politicians claiming four-cost bills and expenses. Do you know I don't understand this monopoly properly, but there seems to be a system in place that is stopping me and my social class. Cause we've got all the stocks, the wealth, the shares, corporations and property. Some say to rig the economy to maintain inequality, cause we're living in this age of hysteria full of banks and charity. Yet the rich guy still seems to profit and live happily. Bankers currently control the currency. They say that money talks, but it's a language only few speak fluently. So what really is the price of freedom? Is it the cost of someone's ridiculously unaffordable life-saving medical treatment? Is it the cost of giving something to a homeless guy who wants it for whatever reason? Is it the cost of university education? This young generation, how many will save and have a pension? Money, what an invention. In some ways, money's a myth. If you're meant to back to draw money out, that amount of money could even physically exist. We work all our lives to save it, we'll leave it behind when we're dead. This piece of paper with a picture of a woman with a crown on her head. So that's why I want to fly away. Fly to a place where money don't matter. To where poor people don't starve while the rich get fatter. To where being born and being inherited this nation's debt. To where money don't buy you love and respect. And to where money ain't the main cause of my emotional stress.
To share it, yeah.
We
green fat cat.
$586.
The cost of providing a meal for a child at school in a developing country, 50 cents per day.
The cost of one general purpose, £500 HE bomb, $25,000.
The cost of curing a cataract in Nepal, $21.71.
The cost of one M1A2 artillery tank, $4.3 million.
The cost of immunising a child in a developing country against most life-threatening diseases, $38.
The cost of one F-22 Raptor fighter jet, $137 million.
The cost of building a latrine in Nigeria, $2,500.
The cost of the Iraq war to the US government, $400 million per day.
The cost of drilling a well in Kenya, $12,500.
Total military spending worldwide per year, $1.7 trillion.
The money required to eradicate hunger for everyone in the world has been estimated at $40 billion a year.
It's a huge sum of money, about as much as the world spends on the military each week.
Suffering. What is it in your life that calls you to be bigger than what you think is possible for yourself and for your world? What is it that calls you to stretch beyond what's comfortable into the places that are uncomfortable, and to realise that you are more powerful and more magical than your mind could have believed?
The year was 1748. The merchant ship Greyhound was returning to Britain when she encountered a great Atlantic storm. On board was John Newton, who would soon make a career shipping slaves to the New World. That 10th of March, wrote Newton, is a day much to be remembered by me. For on that day, the Lord came from on high and delivered me out of deep waters. The sea had torn away the upper timbers on one side and made the ship a mere wreck in a few minutes. It was almost miraculous that any of us survived to relate the story. After a 9-hour stint on the pumps, Newton took the wheel and reflected on his dissolute life. About 6 in the evening, I heard that the ship was free from water. I thought I saw the hand of God displayed in our favor. I began to pray. My prayer for mercy was like the cry of the ravens, which yet the Lord does not disdain to hear. This was the first desire I had grieved for mercy for many years. Nevertheless, Newton's ordeal was to last a further month, until eventually the wind changed direction, and at last the ship found refuge in an Irish lock. Newton later wrote, "My gracious Lord, I have now cause to praise thee for that terrible storm which first shook my infidelity." He would, in due course, write the hymn now known by its opening words, "Amazing grace, how sweet the sound," and finally help abolish the slave trade. It will always be a subject of humiliating reflection to me that I was once an active instrument in a business at which my heart now shudders.
Thank you. honour those who have made a stand for peace. The 14th Dalai Lama, Thich Nhat Hanh, Victor Jara, Rosa Parks, Martin Luther King, Harriet Tubman, Emmeline Pankhurst, Chief Seattle, Mahatma Gandhi, Nelson Mandela, Thomas Perrine Thompson, George Cookham, Winifred Holtby, Susie Meakin Clark, Mary Wollstonecraft, Lillian Balocca, and the Head Start Revolutionaries, William Wilberforce,
Berlin, 1989. The crowd had swollen. People were blowing long alpine horns, which made a huge noise. There were fireworks, kites, flags, dogs, and children. The wall was finally breaking. To get a better view, hundreds of people were climbing onto the shop onto the West German side. All along the building, people poured up the wall at the Berlin Wall itself, which is 3 meters high. People had climbed up and were sitting astride. The final slab was moved away. A stream of East Germans began to pour through. People applauded and slapped their backs. A woman handed me a giant bottle of wine, which I opened, and she and I began to pour cups of wine and hand them to the East Germans. Looking around, I saw an indescribable joy in people's faces. It was the end of the government telling people what not to do. It was the end of the war, the East, the West. If East Germans were going West, then we should go East. So we poured into East Berlin. Around me, people spoke German, French, Polish, Russian, every language. Cheered as the mayors of East Berlin and West Berlin met and shook hands. I stood with several East German guards, their rifles slung over their shoulders. I asked them if they had bullets in those things. They grinned and said no. From some houses, someone had set up loudspeakers and played Beethoven's Ninth Symphony. I'll mention Werder Brüder. All people become brothers. On top of every building were thousands of people. Berlin was out of control. There was no more government, neither in the East nor in West. The police and the army were helpless. The soldiers themselves were overwhelmed by the whole event. They were part of the crowd. Their uniforms meant nothing. The wall was down.
Yeah.
the wild they know.
Superhighway to justice. Humanity's backbone will remain supported by the muscle of justice, love, and togetherness. Our blood won't spill into the streets of our cities. Instead, it will flow through our bodies to the rhythm of righteousness. We dance in unison to the ever-burning bright flame of tomorrow's wake. The new light will rise over the shadows of fear we have within us. Mankind, luminous, we no longer have to live in darkness. Old angst won't move past us. To quote Martin Luther King, none shall be afraid. And after the sun beams on our face, we take to the rain. Though our shoes are damp and heavy, soaked to the skin, amity will give our feet strength. We no longer have to pretend that our wounds are scratches, they're scars now, tales of power overspent. We can't forget, but we can amend. Don't mute the children crying out for brotherhood. Nurture them like a mother would, show them the importance of their neighborhood. We are what we change. And if the ground opens up, splitting the land, we'll link arms, build bridges with our hands, because no distance can break fellowship. No natural disaster can tear away faith. So let's show the marksmen our roads aren't a shooting range. We are what we change.
I believe that love is stronger than hate, and I believe that will is stronger than fate. I believe that truth is stronger than lies, blazing its trail through deceit and disguise. Enters this world with the key to the door. We'll leave as we came, stripped bare of all gain, with only our love to remember. I'll say to you now, I believe that love is stronger than hate. I believe that peace is stronger than war, than the stolen spoils they're fighting for. I believe that right will one day be done, and the Lord will on the deeds of the done. And I want us all to believe in perfection. Together we'll share the key to the door. We'll leave as we came, stripped bare of all gain, with only our love to love is stronger than hate.
Yes, that city is all very green, isn't it? Did you know there was once a time when people poured down those streets like water, thinking they were as unstoppable as the floods? And all the time, Mother Nature was begging them to see that if they didn't live a little differently, she would drown them all and grow trees on their graves. She did her best to warn you. Did you see her work in New Orleans and Bangladesh and that northern coastal town? If only you had realised in time the lesson she was teaching you. Oh, please do eat. There's no meat, of course. We have to do without it most of the time. Although we do try not to judge. Perhaps in your situation, we would have done the same as you. Yes, of course, we miss it. Thanks to the poisons you filled the soil with, there's never enough food. Well, good, but sorry doesn't really cut it. We came from you and the choices you made. We are your children, and we weep as we walk on your bones. Or, welcome to the future. We have so much to offer you here. We chose to move forwards, not backwards. We realised in time that we need to stop shitting where we eat. Yes, that's a road, and yes, those are cars. They're all auto-guided, communally owned, made of 100% recycled materials and powered by the sun. Let's take one to my home. Yes, our city is all very green, isn't it? Did you know there was once a time when cladding and covering your home with plastic, chemicals, and slabs of dead wood? And all the time, Mother Nature was begging us to see that if we just built our homes a little differently, she would bless them with greenery. Thank goodness we realised in time the lesson she was teaching us. Oh, please do eat. There's no meat, of course. We chose to live without it long ago. Although we do try not to judge. Perhaps in your situation, we would have done the same as you. No, of course we don't miss it. Thanks to the work of our food groups, there's such abundance. Thank you, but please, don't be awed. We came from you and the choices you made. We are your children, and we are proud to stand on your shoulders.
And to this land,
my
time when the chained sublime shall walk chainless. So be it written, so be it done. Think not thou art the chosen one, for here comes Mother Cruel, turning king into fool. Peace for a past, that is now, that is here. Peace to the holders of the burning spear. In peace and love, anyhow, I vow the time is now.
Line up, woe for your place in the peaceable kingdom. Yeah, 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 line up, woe for your place in the peaceable kingdom. Yeah, 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 line up, woe.
Differentiation of black and white. Let the Arab man stand by the Israelite. There ain't no creed, there ain't no color, but